guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I am doing a slightly belated 2015 favorites. So I guess we'll just jump right in and talk about my music favorites. So 2015, I got into a lot of more like alternative rock and punk style music rather than my usual, you know, like poppy sort of music. And I got way more into like bands, like mainstream-ish bands. Because usually I'm just into YouTube musicians and people that you've never really heard of before. Most people have never heard of them before. So 2015 was definitely a year where I got into way more styles of music. So my first music mention would have to be Weirdly In Crowd, because in the beginning of the year, last year, I downloaded a couple of their albums and I got obsessed, and that was my first like foray into the punk genre. So I felt it was very necessary to mention them. So Weirdly In Crowd is signed by the same people as All Time Low. So when I subscribed to the YouTube channel of their record company, I came across All Time Low, which I had heard of them before, of course, but I decided I would listen to Kids in the Dark once it came out. And what can I say? I loved it. I loved the song. And I downloaded the album, Future Hearts. And it was just so fantastic. So All Time Low is definitely a favorite. So my favorite albums by them are Future Hearts and also Don't Panic. And my favorite songs by them are The Irony of Choking on a Lightsaber. Nope, it's not a Star Wars song. Lifesaver. Nope. So my favorite songs by them are The Irony of Choking on a Lifesaver and Missing You, of course, and Tidal Waves. And what else do I have on my list? The Reckless and the Brave. That's just a few because I have so many favorite songs by them, but those are some mentions that if you have not heard them, I recommend. And of course, one of my other music favorites, which you should know if you follow all my gaming videos, which if you don't, you should. They're still on this channel. I don't have a separate gaming channel. But one of my favorites is Fall Out Boy. Finally, I got into Fall Out Boy. It was a long time coming, but I watched Big Hero 6 and I heard Immortals, and I literally watched the movie, and in the credit scene and also within the movie they play Immortals, and I'm like, what is this song? It's fantastic. I need to listen to more of it on repeat for like 3 years. So I did. Not 3 years, that's kind of a long time to listen to a song on repeat, but I downloaded Immortals, and then, yeah, that was the beginning. That was the beginning of probably a lifelong obsession. So after that, I downloaded American Beauty, American Psycho, and then Save Rock and Roll, and then I just ended up downloading all of their albums because Apple Music, and I can get all of them for free, for $15 a month or whatever. but my favorite album of theirs is probably controversial because a lot of people don't like it. But my favorite album by them is Folia Do. Just, the lyrics and, the songs. They're so good. I don't know how you can't like that album. I mean, I understand that there's, like, Under the Cork Tree, which has the best lyrics ever. Even Folia Do can't compare to the lyrics of Under the Cork Tree. Nothing I've listened to have ever really compared to the lyrics of Under the Cork Tree. But anyways, that's not even what I was talking about. I was talking about Folia Do and how fantastic it is. For some reason, I seem to be drawn to albums with like a red cover. Cause I also have another favorite in here, an album favorite that has a red cover. And my favorite songs from them are, of course, Immortals. That will always have a place in my heart. And then Say Rock and Roll, that's a really good one. The Ship to Gold Standard, that's so fantastic. Oh, and The Phoenix. The Phoenix is just like, that's how good it is. I can't even find the words to describe how good it is. And then after you get into Fall Out Boy, what's the next natural step? You get into Panic at the Disco. So of course, I went and got into Panic at the Disco. My favorite album from them probably has to be A Fever You Can't Sweat Out, but Pretty Odd. Pretty Odd is just one of the best albums to listen to when you like need to just fall asleep and you need something calming. It's so good. I love the acoustics and I love the acousticness of it. And I love, even though I love electric guitar and like heavy drums, it's just so calming. But A Fever You Can't Sweat Out just has, you know, Panic at the Disco is really diverse because I often, if I need to wake up, I'll listen to A Fever You Can't Sweat Out, because a lot of their songs are really upbeat. And then you have the calmer songs, Pretty Odd. So it's a really diverse band. Not to say that Fall Out Boy isn't, but they only have technically two, pretty much only one slow song. So my favorite songs from Panic at the Disco have to be This Is Gospel, of course. Hallelujah is fantastic. Camisado, again, fantastic. When the Day Met the Night, Northern Downpour, and Always. Oh, Always. I can't really say it's my favorite Panic at the Disco song. That might be This Is Gospel. But Always is so good. Please just stop whatever you're doing except watching this video. Finish this video and then go listen to Always. It's so good. So a lot of you guys may know what my next music favorite is, because after Fall Out Boy and after Panic at the Disco, you should probably know what band I got into. My Chemical Romance. My favorite album from them might be a little bit obvious, but it's The Black Parade. What can I say? It's fantastic. I also love Danger Days. I love all of them, but The Black Parade is just so tragic and so amazing. So my song favorites of My Chemical Romance probably have to be Welcome to the Black Parade, of course, Helena, Na Na Na, all the usuals, Famous Last Words. Also Disenchanted. I feel like Disenchanted is a really underrated song by them. No one ever talks about it, but it's so good. And of course, Cancer, the saddest song I own. And my next music favorite is an album, and it's Blue Neighborhood by Troye Sivan. I would say Troye Sivan, but I didn't get into him this year, or last year. So I just have to say Blue Neighborhood, not counting Wild. That doesn't exist on anywhere anymore, it seems. But yeah, for sure, Blue Neighborhood, it's another one of those albums that's just, it'll put you to bed, because it's so calming and so comforting. Oh man, especially like Suburbia, that's a really calming song. Oh, and Blue. Oh, I love that album. So my favorite songs from Blue Neighborhood have to be Wild, Ease, Blue, of course, Heaven, Youth. So now my book favorites. 2016 was the year that I finally decided to read all the other John Green books apart from The Fault in Our Stars, which wasn't as heartbreaking to me because I was spoiled. By the comments of the trailer of The Fault in Our Stars, which is really annoying. But I decided I especially had to read Paper Towns because the movie came out. But turns out that we didn't even watch Paper Towns until like 3 days ago, which was, it was a great movie. Go see Paper Towns. It was actually like way better than people give it credit for. It was just a really fun movie. Anyways, that's not even like a 2015 favorite. Why am I talking about it? So anyways, after all that, I finally came to the conclusion of what my favorite John Green book is. And you could argue that this isn't really a John Green book because it was written with David Levithan, but still, I'm counting it. Otherwise, it would probably have to be, probably Paper Towns, maybe Looking for Alaska. Of course, Tiffios. I'm not even counting Tiffios. Okay, so anyways, Will Grayson. I love Will Grayson. It was just, I loved David's writing style, and I thought it really complemented John Green's writing style and the plot. It really mixed in well together, and I loved Will Grayson. And I also read Hold Me Closer, and that was fantastic. I've never read any book like it. Please tell me if there are any books like it. It's like in the form of like a script for a play. It was fantastic because it was just telling the story of Tiny, who's such a great character. And yeah, I could go on and on about Will Grayson, but Will Grayson and Hold Me Closer, both in my favorites for this year, last year. So I also have to mention the Maze Runner series. I have an interesting history with the Maze Runner series because I first started reading The Maze Runner, the first book in The Maze Runner, very cleverly called, and I didn't like it. I thought it was like really boring at first, and I wasn't really in a mood for that kind of book anyways, so I dropped it for a really long time. And then finally, I picked it up again, and it was actually, I finished it that time, and it was really good. It was definitely way better than I thought it was. And so I read Scorched Trials and I read The Death Cure. I have not read The Kill Order yet, but I suppose it'll be like as good as the others. But it was fantastic. It wasn't the best book series I've ever read by any means, but I really like the writing style. I might actually decide to read the... So I might actually read James Dashner's other series, The Eye of Minds. Is that what the series called? Well, that's what the first book was all called anyways. And so I might read that because I really liked the writing style of The Maze Runner. I think that was like the best part about it. I also liked the mystery. Since we didn't really know what was gonna happen next, at least I didn't really know what was gonna happen next, I pretty much knew how it would end, but I didn't know how they would get to that point. So yes, The Maze Runner was a really shocking favorite of last year. So my last book favorite would have to be The Mortal Instruments. I really liked that series. At first I wasn't sure how much I liked it, but then as the books progressed, I started loving the characters so much. So yes, The Mortal Instruments. It's taken me way too long to finish it, considering how much I like it. But I'm almost done with the last book, and yeah, The Mortal Instruments is just fantastic. I'm planning on posting a rant about how amazing it is and how infuriating a lot of the characters are. I'll put that in a card somewhere. I'm pretty sure it's over there. Click on the I and you will be taken to that video. Spoiler alert. But yes, The Mortal Instruments is fantastic. I don't think I've ever yelled so much at a book in my life. So a couple quick favorites before we sign off. So YouTubers, I was really into smaller YouTubers this year. Like people who aren't like over a million subscribers. Because those were kind of usually the people I ended up watching before. But this year I got way more into like smaller YouTubers. Like Ashley Mardell, I got really into her because she's so fantastic. She posts really good like educational content about like LGBT topics and such. And then James Chats, just a fun vlogger that posts like nerdy things, and he's just really hilarious and I love him. And Nathan and Rose is a great one. They post like educational content about environment, like literally anything you can think of. They post educational content and also vlogs, and they're also hilarious. So yes, they're fantastic. And I also got really into BookTube this year, specifically the whole Booksplosion crew, Pauline Bananas Books, the Katie Tastic, and Jesse the Reader. They're all fantastic, and they share like my same reading, not reading style, reading taste. And they share the same taste in books as me. And they were the reason that I read Illuminae. I also posted a review on the book Illuminae by Amy Cotton and J. Kristoff, so I can put that in the card there too. Go check that out, read the book, then go watch that video. But you can also watch my non-spoiler review if you wanna hear what it's about. And yeah, those are my YouTube favorites. And finally, two little mentions. Video games. My favorites were Fire Emblem, which is just, it has like an awesome fighting style. I love like the fighting aspect of the game, and I love the art style, and I just love the game. It was fantastic. I'm interested to like play through it a bunch more times to get all the different endings, and yes, I loved it. So yes, Fire Emblem, I cannot wait for the next game that's coming out, which will have like two in one where you can play as a bad guy and you can also play as a good guy, and then there's a third one. Yes, I'm so excited for the new Fire Emblem games that's coming out. And also my other favorite is The Legend of Zelda Wind Waker. A lot of people don't like the art style of that one, but I personally, I'm a fan. I can't really say I like it better than the usual art style, because the usual art style is just stunning, but this one is interesting. Like it's not the usual style you see for these kind of games, so it's nice to see that kind of style. And it was just, since it was remastered for the Wii U, it looks so great in HD. So yes, The Legend of Zelda Wind Waker, me and my brother finished it. We take turns playing the game, and we finally finished it. The boss was easy, but it was just a fantastic game overall. And one quick favorite before we sign off, I was a huge fan of Welcome to Night Vale this year. Not that I'm not still a huge fan, but I think you understand what I mean. I love Welcome to Night Vale. It's just fantastic. It's like, oh my god, I cannot talk enough about Welcome to Night Vale. I might make like an entire video just all about Welcome to Night Vale, but it's a podcast. If you don't know, it's a podcast, and it's like, it's telling the story of this really quirky town in the middle of a desert, and it's just, it's hilarious, and it's in the format of like a radio show, and yeah, it's fantastic, it's weird, it's everything you could have ever wanted for, you could have ever hoped for and wanted. That's what That's what I was trying to say. Okay, I'm tired, I can't talk. So, I think that's about it for this video. If you liked it, then you can push the thumbs up button, because you all know what happens if you don't push the thumbs up button. Yep, neither do I, but you know, you can push it anyways. And then I'll have all my social medias down in the comments down below. Not the comments, I say that like every time, in the description down below. You can tell me your favorites or your opinion on any of my favorites in the comments down below. Where you can talk about Fall Out Boy, Panic! At the Disco, any other things I should check out, please tell me. Let's have a discussion in the comments down below. And yes, go check out all my other videos, subscribe, do all that stuff. Share this video with your friends, get me to 20 subscribers. Yes. And until next time, may the odds be ever in your favor. Goodbye. That's his old outro. Anyways, that's still not my outro.